Hello, people. This is your good old friend Dom. Having some, coming with something special for you, which is a holiday cube draft. Yeah, because it's holidays, Christmas and shit. So, yeah, the draft just started, and this is what we're looking at. I do have my preferences in holiday cube. My highest preference is the sort of balance, wildfire. Like just win with over the top things, leaving with your opponent with no ball whatsoever, that deck. However, in this pack, I think I'm gonna try something maybe fairly boring for you. I see a Figure of Destiny and the Goblin Guide and the Chain Lightning and the Nevalon Tridus, which are all very good in mono red. So I think one of these is pretty certainly going to table. I think I'm going to start off with Figure of Destiny here. Just, I think it's maybe a little bit weaker than Goblin Guide, but you could also play it in mono white or just in a white base deck, like overall. And I'm just going to maybe wheel the Goblin Guide, maybe wheel Chain Lightning. And if you see that red isn't open, we didn't give up on that much because we might still play the figure. Like in this pack, which. Where we have absolutely nothing for mono red. That's kind of a bummer. Oh, scratch that. We do have a Skull Clamp. Skull Clamp is pretty insane, right? Yeah, I think we should just pick the Skull Clamp. The other option would be the Spectral Procession for maybe a white based aggro deck, but let's just pick Skull Clamp. Skull Clamp is the nuts. Has always been. So yeah, I joined the Swiss queue here. Just so that you guys get the maximum amount of value out of this video, which we want to make certain that you do. So yeah, the reason for me not doing any videos whatsoever is that my life was fairly busy. I recently moved. I had exams to do with mixed success, and just all that kind of stuff. But now that I have a few hours for myself, I thought why not make another video. So you'll probably hear from myself in the future more frequently than in the past 2 months, because yeah, those were fairly busy months. How on earth is Solring still in this pack? Are these people crazy? Solring is just another butters. Yeah, we're definitely gonna pick that. Not much red, which means that the mono red plan might not work out that well. What else do we have? We have a couple of signets. I recently had a deck with 6 of out of the 10 signets, and I think I cut one. But I did play a Mindstone. That deck was awesome. We had played it with one of my friends. We had 7 Planeswalkers, and just all the Wrath of Gods in the world and balance. Balance is my all-star in this holiday queue. But every time I resolve balance, it's just an instant, huge, massive blowout. It's like Wrath of God for 2 mana or double Stone Rain or yeah. Balance has been one of the MVPs of this holiday queue for me. So yeah, let's see where this leads us. Mana Vault as well, really? Might just have to pick Mana Vault here. I mean, it's not the best in Mono Red, but it has to be best in Incinerator Molten Rain, even in Mono Red. And the other good cards here are Lingering Souls. Verdant Catacombs is pretty okay. Unexpectedly Absent is okay. But I think I'm just gonna stick with the artifacts. This way, also, if we ever get a balance, we can just snatch it. Because balance turns out it's good with mono artifacts. Yeah. So. What else did I play in this queue? I played a couple of just. Fair creature decks and like a Buck come into play dot deck with Recurring Nightmare, which was pretty good. Not that successive with the whole Tinker shenanigans. Oh, Shrine of Burning Rage. That's good in mono red. Apart from that, we have Heartbeat is good in the combo deck. I had a Heartbeat combo deck recently, so that's just why I'm looking at it. All these other cards don't really excite me that much. Wolfie Silverheart is just a huge dork. Brainstorm, you really have to build your deck around. Now I'm just gonna stick with the Shrine here. Turn one Shrine of Solring. It's pretty good. And if we don't end up red, yeah, well. Then we didn't miss out on that much. but Reds didn't seem to be like overly close. I mean, we had some picks that we could have made. So yeah, let's just see where this leads us. There's an Arc Trail for the red deck. There's also a Leshnorn, which is just a very, very strong card in general. But I don't think I really want to jump into white for a Leshnorn. I think I'm just going to stick with the red plan and pick up the Arc Trail. It's not the most exciting of cards, but every once in a while you just 2-for-1 your opponent. Like, against the white deck, you just kill their 1-drop and the 2-drop or something like that. Yeah, we could pick up this Ranger of Eos because it does work with Figure of Destiny. Yeah, the only red card really is Celest Conscripts, which I don't like that much. But I still don't think that any of the other cards are that much better. I mean, Recurring Nightmare would have been good, but we have one creature so far, so that's just not gonna happen. So I'm probably just gonna pick the Conscripts. Yeah, the Oracle is pretty strong as well. But yeah, it's probably too late for green. Siege Gang Commander is pretty good with Skull Clamp. But this is an Upheaval. Wow, I didn't even see that. Upheaval is the nuts. And we have Mana Vault and Soul Ring already. Do we really need a Siege Gang Commander? I don't really think we do. Yeah, let's just pick the Upheaval and see what happens. I mean, this card is basically just a nut. Yeah, okay, all the other two red cards were taken, so red is just not gonna happen. So now we have to focus on something different. Yeah, thank you, Gaspers guy. So we're probably not gonna play this. Probably not gonna play the Figure and the Conscripts, I'm still not sure about. I'm definitely gonna pick the Rule Signet here. So yeah, red is definitely closed. So let's just go for Upheaval and Signet. That's a good old tactic. Just signet them, play an Upheaval, play all of your stuff. Yeah, that should be alright. And red is just, yeah, not going to happen. Unfortunately. So we definitely missed out on some good cards, but we didn't pass the balance. At least I can say that, so at least we can signet the balance. And the signets keep on coming. I really don't know why people don't pick signets. Signets are so awesome. Just do everything you want. Even off-color signets. I mean, with Upheaval, it really doesn't matter all that much. Skullclamp, Zealous Conscripts, Nocturne are also a little bit on the weak side. What the hell? It's just signets over signets over signets. Yeah. Just pick more signets. I don't really care about double white, unexpectedly absent kind of cards. Woo, Heartbeat. Heartbeat could do something pretty ridiculous together with Upheaval. So, yeah, at this point, I'm just gonna hide all that stuff. I'm still wanna. Ooh, Brain Freeze. Maybe we're Storm. Well, who knows? So the Skull Clamp is probably not going to happen too because we have no creatures so far. So I'm just gonna hide it. Maybe we'll play it in the end if we get some like Mana Dorks. Agony Warbles are not something I'm interested in. But this looks interesting. I just messed up my table. So just hang on for a second. Alright, we're back. So the cards that are interesting here are Primeval Titan for sure. Thran Dynamo is pretty strong. Preordain is pretty good. Xenagos, Garruk, those are all pretty strong. What could we wheel out of this pack that we really want? Probably nothing really. Maybe a Preordain, but it's the only blue card, so that's very unlikely. Maybe the Karoo. Even though Karoos are pretty bad with Upheaval. Maybe the Crucible? No, Crucible doesn't really do anything. I'm just gonna pick Primetime here. Primetime into Upheaval is really all I wanna do. And the Rofellos. Jeez. Wildfire works pretty good with like a million signets. But maybe we could wheel it. I don't really know. We could pick Rofellos, but I think this is just going to put us into a pretty weird spot. We could also pick Ancestral Vision just because it draws us three cards. and storms out with brain freeze and stuff. Yeah, we could do that. We could pick the Mind Stone, but we only have 6 mana artifacts. Jeez. Yeah, and the Wildfire could might as well wheel. And it's also double red, and we have one red fixing card. So I'm just gonna pick the Ancestral Vision. It's a pretty good card, like, overall. And here, what? Mana Crypt? Really? Really? They really want to make me do it, right? They really want me to pick this Mana Crypt. So there's a Cryptic Command and Ooze. Chandra, which could be useful. No, who am I kidding? As if I could ever resist the Mana Crypt. Ooh, Armageddon and Mox Emerald. Wow. They're both very good in this deck, I think. Armageddon just cleans out all the lands and leaves us with a bunch of signets. It has to be good. So also the Coast, which would be a nice land. But there's really no way that I'm not picking a Mox Emerald. I mean, come on, it's a freaking Mox. Ral's Eric was also in that pack, by the way. So yeah, the way this deck is gonna work is we're just gonna play a million mana artifacts and then upheaval and do anything, really. Savannah would be a nice dual land if we get a Mirari's Wake. Trigon Predator absolutely annihilates us. Yeah, I still think I want to pick the Savannah here. Just in case we pick up a Mirari's Wake. Palancron would be pretty good in this deck too, all of a sudden. Get it with like the Heartbeat. And yeah, let's see. Ooh, Misty Rainforest. And nothing else really. Lotus Bloom is interesting with upheaval, but after all, not even that great. Aeon Chronicler is okay with upheaval because you can suspend it and then do shenanigans like upheaval and then the turn before it comes back. But I'm just gonna pick the Rainforest. It's too important to have the fixing, and this also gets the Savannah if we ever want to play white. Let's see, we got 3, 2 black signets, like 2 green signets, 2 white signets, 1 blue signet. Yeah, our signet count is probably high enough. I really don't know how this deck is going to turn out, but we do have all the mana in the world. So from now on, we could just pick anything that says draw a card or anything. Treachery? You guys must be kidding. Ugh. This makes my food come back up. My dinner all over my computer. Yeah, treachery. Treachery, by the way, is bonkers insane. This combo's really nice with Heartbeat, if this ever comes up. And it's just overall probably one of the best 3 blue cards. I think it's something like Treachery, Upheaval, Shackles, maybe. No, I'm not even sure about that. Woo, this is all very interesting. Eternal Witness, probably gonna be pretty insane. But we don't have any card or spells, really. So, yeah, the Green Suns only gets us prime time. Night is interesting. So is Flooded Strand. Arbor Elf is a Mana Dork, which is always good. I'm probably just gonna pick the Witness. Let's just pick the Witness. And we're always gonna have something to do with it. I hope. Chancery fixes white as well, but still we don't really have. We really don't have anything in white, and Karuza are pretty bad with upheaval. Yeah, my friend just told me that he got appeal 7th. We got appeal like a millionth pick, so yeah. I really don't know. Probably just gonna pick the Crucible. Maybe we get more fetches, who knows. Wildfire Tabled, okay, that's something. Oh, but Aetherling Upheaval. Wow, okay. Never mind the Wildfire. Aetherling Upheaval is just way too good. Yeah, let's just respond to Hannes. If you're a valiant follower of my videos, you must know Hannes. He had a video with me. Probably just gonna pick Tooth and Nail here, yeah. Okay, so let's pick up Myakos house because it's fixing and I'm interested in the force spike. Oh, goodbye. Goodbye, Trigon. It was nice knowing you. I picked this because maybe I want to play it, but mostly just because it completely, it utterly ruins us. Just does us in on its own. The only thing we can really do is play Treachery. Like, as if we could, because it's going to kill our lands. Route or Hermit? Just going to pick the Route. Maybe we play white, who knows. Ooh, Electrolyze. We could splash that easily. We got a Gruul Signet to splash it, and that's about it. Okay, maybe it's not that easy to splash. But we'll see. So Palanquin would be pretty okay. And also anything that says draw card. We have some late game. Kozilek. Yeah, why not? Winterorb is pretty good with a million mana artifacts. But Tropical Island. Tropical Island is tempting. Or Genesis Wave. Should we go for Genesis Wave? No, this is gonna wheel. Genesis Wave is gonna wheel for sure. And what is it really doing in this deck? Sorry, Hannes, can't chat with you right now. Probably just gonna go for Kozilek, just because it's like our way to win the game. Yeah, this sounds reasonable. Kozilek is a good one. So it's probably not playing the route. Probably not playing the brain freeze. Probably not the electrolyze, and also very probably not the crucible. Armageddon. We already established that Armageddon is really good in this deck. But did I hide something that I didn't want to hide? Let's see. So sure. No, I didn't. Ugh. Never mind. Okay, so GTA is not going to happen in this deck. No way. Shardless Agent seems pretty good because it cascades us into a mana artifact like every time. Signet would be like the safe pick. I really don't want Armageddon with all this high end stuff. Let's just pick Shardless Agent. Hide the brain freeze again and the warp. We might just splash for Arctroid and Electrolyze. That's something that we could do. Yeah, let's leave this up for now. Crucible we're probably not gonna play ever. Oh, Sphinx's Revelation. This is a reason to play blue. To play white. There's also the Thragfather. There is Polluted Delta, which doesn't really get us anything. Yeah, we're probably just gonna splash a little bit of white. We have two white signets with the Sphinx's Rev. Sphinx's Rev is just too insane. Yeah. Ref it is. So that means we need the Also signet, we need the Gruul signet for green, the Golgari signet for green, and the Azuri signet for white, so I really don't think we want the red. I mean, we can always sideboard it in against an aggro deck. Are we actually running low playables? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. And then a million of them are mana artifacts. So we're actually kind of low on playables. But we shall see. Ooh, Garruk. Garruk. And Show and Tell. Wow. Do we really have... Yeah, I think we have to pick Show and Tell here. We have Kozilek and Prime Time already. And we might always get something nice. Garruk, on the other hand, is... really insane with Heartbeat of Spring and just very good on its own. Screw it. Show and Tell it is. I really can't resist these cards. Maybe I have a problem. Maybe I do. I agree. But I just can't resist the unfairness. It's a bummer we don't have this natural order now. Really would have liked natural order, but then again we don't really have creatures. Yeah, this deck looks okay. Not like the best. Ooh, Avenger of Zendikar. Or a Eureka. No, we have to take the Avenger. Yeah. It's very good with Show and Tell. So he asks us if Wukong, Primus, Angel, Simic Sky, Swallower, what's the best or worst of them? I really like Primus. I love Angel of Despair. Probably gonna say the Sky Swallower. But it really depends on the matchup. Yeah, I think against control, you want spot Sky Swallower if they have like spot removal. And probably over Angel. Oh, hello Fountain. Hello. Hello Fountain. Yeah, we're gonna pick that. It's gonna get fetched by Misty Rainforest and it fixes a Sphinx's Wrath. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 23 cards, counting the Skull Clamp and a million mana artifacts. Blah, that sounds about right. Ooh, Garruk, the Caller of the Beasts. Or the Primal Hunter. Or just some sort of Garruk. It's that or Glenelendra Archmage. I think I'm just gonna pick the Garruk. We could Show and Tell in the Garruk. That'd be pretty nice. Oh no, we can't. Scratch that. It's a Planeswalker. Planeswalkers don't work with that. So, Skull Clamp, still not sure. Sower of Temptation. 8 pick. There we have it. Card is ridiculous. Breeding Pool would also be pretty good, but Sower of Temptation is just ridiculous. So people really don't. We really only have to cook blue cards like a Sower, Treachery, Upheaval, and Aetherling and Sphinx's Wrath, and Ancestral Vision. Yeah, we di really didn't bother with this with the semi-good blue cards. The mana is gonna be okay, I think. I mean, we're just two colors. Primus is insane. Primus is really insane. Oh, we did wield the G-Wave. Shall we go for it? Shall we just G-Wave it up? We'll have to do like G-Wave for a million, but we could do that with Heartbeat. Maybe Impulse is just better. Or maybe Winter Orb with that many mana artifacts. Also the Mana Crypt. Yeah, I really think we want Winter Orb here. It's a not a fair card. Oh, and even more signets. Alright. Okay, so we have the Signet Winter Orb plan. And we have shown the Show and Tell plan and also just the general grand plan. So this deck looks like it can do a lot of things. Now we just have to hope that it can do one of these things really good. Hey, Thraktusk. Our good old friend the Thrakfighter. We could splash Catastrophe and blow up a land, or we could just pick the Imbrix Stump Howler. This guy rarely misses. I still don't want it main deck because it's not gonna miss our stuff, and it does kill our stuff. So Gideon Jarrah or Kargan, Dragon Lord or Emeria Angel. I'm probably just gonna counter draft the Dragon Lord. And gonna counter draft the Ram Gang. How is this possible that no one went into red? This is really strange. Oh well. I mean, we have a sweet one here. Basically, like all the mana in the world and huge stuff to do with it. So let's see how we build this abomination. So I'm just gonna do that off screen and see you back for a deck discussion. So I think this is what we're gonna go with. We only have 14 lands. This is what it says, but we really have 16 with Mana Crypt and Mox Emerald, and apart from that, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 other mana cards. So we are up to 24 mana cards. That should really be enough. Plus, like this, we don't have to play any of the suboptimal cards like Stump Howler. Really, stop that. Okay. So yeah, I think this is what we're gonna go with. We could play the Hoppy, but it seems a little bit ambitious. I mean, just the fact that you have to play it and he gets to go at your throat first, and we have so many mana, so much mana, that we really don't need the Heartbeat, I don't think. Basically, our aim is just to ramp up to six really quickly on at Primeval Titan and then go anywhere from there. Apart from that, we could ramp up to 7 or then 9 or 10. But, I mean, Heartbeat of course would be good in his deck, don't get me wrong. Something I just realized is that we could go Shardless Agent into Winter Orb, which would be kind of suboptimal. We might have a case for... We might play the Heartbeat, who knows. No, let's not. I think there are just too many degenerate decks around to punish you for that. So yeah, this is our deck. And I'm going to pause the video again and see you guys for round one. So, here we are for round one. We lost Tyro, so we're not going to play first, I don't think. Playing against Taric, which is probably the evil twin brother of Garruk. I could imagine, but it might be something completely different, who knows. Anyway, it's someone who takes quite a time to decide on whether he wants to play first or not, so I'm just going to pause the video. So, after 3 minutes of waiting, the guy finally came back, and is now deciding whether or not to mulligan. We're definitely not going to mulligan. I mean, this hand basically just needs anything to just go off. We have upheaval. The only bad thing that could happen is if our opponent had a million counter spells. Let's just hope he doesn't have that. We're probably not going to leave with the mana crypt, I don't think. I mean, you will, depending on what we draw. But just because of the risk of dying to mana crypt, we're probably just gonna hang on here, unless we have a very compelling reason to play it. Otherwise, no, the plan should be pretty much clear. Is he really double queuing? Is he doing that to us? Because he came back just to keep his hand and... Oh, okay. No, we're not gonna mulligan. So do your worst. His worst is a stomping ground and 2 damage. Does this mean Goblin Guide? No, Rakdos Captain. Okay. So we draw another Signet. I think against this hand we probably have to upheaval as early as possible. But it still doesn't really change the clock. I mean, we could always fit in the mana crypt. And we don't really have 3 drops or 4-5 drops that we want to cast next turn. Except for Garruk, which we can't even cast. Or Thraktusk, maybe. Yeah, if we draw a Thraktusk, this was pretty poor. But again, especially against the red deck, an early mana crypt without any action can just really quickly take you out of the game. I mean, basically just lightning bolts you twice and then you just lose. So it's just a little bit too dangerous for us, for me here. So, yeah. He's... Depending on what he follows this up with, we could be in trouble if we don't draw something to stabilize or a way to win the game. Maybe we will have to go for the defensive upheaval, which is something I never really liked. He fetches up a plateau, so nice Niagara deck here. Voice of Resurgence, okay. I like his deck. It's a good old honest creature deck. Ooh! And we are punished. The punishment. So now, yeah, this really sucks. It's like the only thing that really punishes us here. Okay, so we probably just go Simic Signet and pass here. No need to run out the Mana Crypt now. It's too late for that. Next turn we can run out Signet, Mana Crypt Signet Thraktusk. That's gonna be pretty good. Oh, an upheaval Thraktusk? Jeez. Jeez. So if you, ugh. Ah, we can still play the Thraktusk next turn. Nothing to see here, folks. Wow. This is constructed. What is he doing to us here? This is just perverted. This is just really, really filthy. So let's hope we don't lose too many coin flips to this mana crypt. Yeah, we should really hope for that. The Thraktusk is gonna be, is a good one here. Very good one. Man, this start. This is amazing. Maybe we just have to go for the defensive upheaval next turn. Might well be the thing to do here. In that case, we want to block the Voice of Resurgence, I think. It's when it dies. Okay. In that case, we probably just want to block the Rectus Keckler. We go down to 12, and heads or tails? Heads or tails? I can choose heads. Rats. Avenger of Zendikar. Does that change things? I mean, we wait a turn, then we could go uphill for Rectusk and still have a land drop. The question is, do we die if we do that? We'd take 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe 3 from the mana crypt, so if he has a burn spell, we're dead. And I really would like to not have this mana crypt stick around. Whatever. Whatever. Let's just go for it. Yeah, maybe this kills us. Who knows? Maybe we just get lucky with the mana crypt. Really. Not playing this mana crypt during turn 1 really bites me. He does have Boon Seder. Wow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So if you block the Hooligan, the mana crypt might just kill us. Who gives a crap? Let's just take the risk. Oh, that's 9? Wow, I'm the worst. Yeah, maths is hard. Maths is really, really hard. Still don't think we were in a great position anyways, but ugh. This game was just a train wreck. Really apologize for you guys. To you guys. We could maybe sideboard in the Arc Trail. Don't really know if it's good against him. Alright, whatever. Let's just run it back. Oh, maybe the Heartbeat. Yeah, Heartbeat might be nice. Probably for Winter Orb. Yeah. That should be okay. Because what's he really gonna do with Heartbeat? Like, play his two remaining cards at the point we play it, where we play it? It's not gonna be the best for him. Arc Trail should be nice. So, yeah. Heartbeat. This hand has not much going on. It's probably just gonna die to a slur of creatures, and we have no ramp and anything, so we just have to mulligan it, I think. This hand is not much better, but it can be if we hit our third land. So definitely not gonna mulligan it. No need to play the Mox Emerald right now. We might just run into like a Mox Taint 3 Hooligan start. Question is just if we go for Shardless Agent or Show and Tell next turn if we draw the land. And the answer is Show and Tell, by the way, in case you were wondering. Is this the Keckler again? No, it's a Wattler Kettle. Even better. Wow. Wow, we're really doing it here. So yeah. Let's cast Mana Crypt. Yeah, we can't. I was thinking about playing the Shardless Agent, cascading into a Signet, but then we ran 1 mana short. So yeah, just cast Show and Tell. We're gonna choose Primeval Titan. I choose you, Primeval Titan. What's he gonna choose? A Plated Geopede. That's cute. Yes, please. For Hallowed Fountain and Savannah, I think. Yeah. Do we want to play 2 life? No. Come to play tapped anyways, right? Yeah. Okay. So much for that. Next turn, we're gonna play Shardless Agent and get a bit closer to casting Avenger. Next turn, the turn after that, we can cast Avenger and get 2 counters on it. That's also going to be pretty good. So he pluses the Geopede and he has a fetch. So that means I don't really want to block the Geopede here. And he could... Nah, he could probably have safely attacked with it. I wouldn't have blocked it. Yes, choose heads again. Rats! I'm never going to choose heads again. This coin flipping thing is stupid. Yeah. So what could we can hit the Signet basically with this Shardless Agent, so let's just see which Signet we hit. And we can't cast anything with that anyways. Oh, the Bulgari Signet. Okay. Fair enough. What? Okay. There he is. And then we attack with Prime Time. Get ourselves two shiny new lands. Probably, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can get a Rainforest and a Normal Forest. So that way we can next turn. Next turn we can cast Avenger and crack the Rainforest. And he just took it. So yeah, he's pretty much dead. But that was a ridiculous start after his ridiculous start. Oh. Never mind what I said about being almost dead. I mean, that doesn't change much, but it's still a pretty cool play. Let's see, if we block here, we can take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7 damage. I really don't want to take 7 damage. Taking 7 damage sounds stupid. He could sack a land to pump the Wild the Cattle, but he's not going to. It's okay. Okay, so... yeah, heads is gonna work this time. Yeah, heads, go us. So let's cast the Emerald. Let's activate the Signet. Yeah. Let's choose to pay with the colorless mana. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, wait. We could fit in the Gruul Signet here. Yeah, let's just do that. It's 4. Okay, with this, 5, 6, 7. Avenger. Good game. Yeah, it's pretty much GG here. I mean, these things are gonna grow ridiculously big. Forest Island, yeah. Yes. And yes. Yeah, these things are gonna be like 3/4. So there's really not much you can do from this point. Yeah. No, there's really not much that you can do from this point. Or I couldn't think of anything. Yeah. Okay. So after having some more information about his deck, we're just probably gonna stick to our setup here. We could... what's not good against him? Maybe the Mana Crypt is just too much of a liability? Then again, if it works, it's so insane. Yeah, I'm gonna leave in the Mana Crypt. I mean, at some point it will kill us again, but yeah. We could also just not draw it. So this hand is ridiculous if we draw green mana. And we have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9-ish green sources. Thraktusk is so good and Sol Ring is so good. Okay, I'm gonna take the gamble. Just because of out of a concession to his deck. Because I think his deck is really strong. And having an early Thraktusk could just be like half the game here. Oh, nah, that's the wrong signet. Goblin Guide is okay. Goblin Guy could draw us into a sweet little forest action here. Yeah. Oh, Mr. McAfee is... No. Mr. McAfee is not happy. So, okay, we're back. After dealing with Mr. McAfee. I hate this guy. Really annoying. Forest! Rats. The wrong signet again. Yeah, we have to draw forest pretty fast. And he also had the hole. Which isn't even that bad. Yeah, maybe that hand was a bad keep. That might well be true, but I really think his deck is very strong. And we have to take a gamble. Somewhat against him. Oh, there's the forest. Okay. Ooh. So let's see. We could cast the Mana Vault of the Signet have one floating. I have 4 mana, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 mana. But only one green. Oh no. Yeah, only one green because we have to play the Heartbeat this turn. But could we go Heartbeat into Thraktusk? No, because we still have to play the Heartbeat this turn. Okay, so no Heartbeat action. Yeah, this is kind of sad. I really wanted to play out this Heartbeat here. But nothing we can do. We have to get down this Thraktusk this turn just to start blocking, basically. Let's get a Savannah, I think. Or maybe just a normal forest, in case he has like non-basic land hate. And we have the white mana, so yeah. Just go for that. Pay this with this, pay this with this, 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 and Thraktusk. Okay. So Thraktusk down. Still, he is putting a lot of pressure on us, so if he has the removal for the... Yeah, removal for Thraktusk isn't even that great. Yeah, we're still not in a good position. That's what I'm trying to say here. Next turn, we can go Heartbeat into nothing, basically. If we draw a second green, that would be fantastic. Sword of War and Peace, okay. That doesn't really change anything. I mean, it doesn't give anything protection from... I mean, it does change things, of course, but not right now, at least. Just means that we trade with Goblin Guide. Yeah. A forest. Hello. So block the guide. Yeah, now we could go Heartbeat into Witness and take back the Thraktusk to buy us more time. Or could we go Heartbeat into... Let's see. So we play this. We have 4 mana. We have 4 mana. That means we have 2 floating when we cast a Heartbeat. That's 2... 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so we could get the Avenger down this turn. At least that's what I'm thinking. Yeah, if this works out, let's go through this again. This is 2 mana. So, together with the Mana Vault, it's 4 mana. 4 mana plus this equals Heartbeat. We have 2 left. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, that does work. Well, that's cute. So we're probably not gonna attack with this Thraktusk here. So let's just exercise our game, so to speak. Use this. Tap this for 3. Cast Heartbeat of Spring. Use this. And cast Avenger of Sending Car. With a couple of friends. Now we could attack him with the beast, but then he has good attacks again, so we're not going to do that. So I don't want to count him out, really not. I mean, this is cube, so anything could happen. Next turn we're going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 mana, if we untap the mana vault, that is. Or we could untap the mana vault and tap it again. No, wait. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, we have enough mana to cast Eternal Witness into Thraktusk. It's going to get us back up to 15. He has... What does he have? Or we could also Eternal Witness for Misty Rainforest. That's also a thing. Does he have, like, Huntmaster with the Palace? Okay, that's okay. Huntmaster, not a big deal. So we're just gonna start growing these tokens, I think. He equips the Huntmaster. Huh. But he really can't attack. I know. So we probably wanna untap this Mana Vault, I think. Let's see. Doing it wrong here. I did play him with Mana Vault before, but these old cards always confuse me. Okay, let's untap it. Ah, that's even better. That means that we can now go Witness into Misty or Witness into Thraktusk. He's on one card in his hand, and we're at 12. Huh. Misty just kills him quicker, but I don't think this is gonna be a big problem. So let's just, yeah, let's just go for Thraktusk here. 1-2, colorless, use this. So witness, get back Thragfather. Cast the Thragfather. And then we can, now I see it. We could have attacked with Avenger, just so that he will block it and then get more value. But yeah, I think 5 life also has its merits here. I mean, he will have burn spells at some point. He's not gonna play burn spells, what is he really doing? So now he just flips the Huntmaster, shoots the one of her tokens, I would guess. Yeah, I think he's gonna just shoot one of her tokens. Yeah, that's a bummer. The poor thing. We didn't even know it. No, let's not do that. Let's cast this. Don't play the tool. Don't pay the tool to life. And we're gonna put a counter on all of his things. And now he's got his 6/6, and we can attack. Okay. That doesn't matter. The board is as good as stalled. Now he could start casting 2 spells to flip back his Ravager and kind of go off with it. We really should have attacked with his Avenger when we had the Witness play, because it's gonna would have been way better, of course. So now he's just emptying his hand, but all of our tokens basically blank this. We really want an upheaval. We really, really, really want an upheaval. Upheaval would be good. Trigon Predator. That's also pretty good. That's gonna kill his sword. So let's cast this. And keep the other thing. Oh. Forget about the heartbeat. Like this. Yes, please. Yes, okay. So now we could attack with Thraktusk. He doesn't really have a good block for it. No, it really doesn't. Yeah, let's just attack with Thraktusk. And he is probably, I think he's just gonna take it. No? I would just take it if I were him. Or he could like block it with some wolf tokens or curd apes. Anyway, we're gonna eat 2 creatures here and get 1 back if he blocks. Maybe he blocks it with Hooligan and Pilgrim. Yeah, let's see. He just trades it with Nakadal. So we basically 2-for-1 him. That's okay. So now he won't play anything and then have the Ravager of the Fells shoot us. Yeah, this is a way we could potentially die. But I think with having like 16 turns or 16-ish turns, I think we can survive that long enough to deal with his things. Ah, he can shoot the witness. Sorry, I forgot about that. No, that's not. Oh, show and tell. Yeah, this is exactly what we wanted. We were planning for this to happen. Now let's just attack with the beast, because the other guys are kind of blanked by this huge guy here. Yeah, let's get rid of the sword. Now does he have 2 spells again? That would be really lucky. Really, really lucky. No, he doesn't have anything. Okay. Let's not untap this. Ugh. Now we could flip that back, but we don't want to. No, we're just gonna slow. Actually, we could just set up for the most ridiculous upheaval of all time. I mean, chances is that we will draw more spells. Always screw that up. Stupid heartbeat. Yeah. Chances are that we're not gonna run out of spells. So that his Ravager doesn't wood flip in our during our turn. So yeah. Domri Raid. Oh, that's gonna increase his creatures per turn count quite a bit, actually. And he misses. Okay. At least. Everything else would have been unfair. Does he have the removal for the Trigon? No. Okay. So, and we draw the Sower of Temptation. Ooh-wee. So, let's just cast this. Steal this. And attack with this. The Domri Raid. And do we flip this back? No, I don't think so. And deactivates Domri. And hits Tree Speaker. How lucky! How lucky can one be? So much mana. He can like level it up straight away. Like to the highest levels. Beyond reason. Yeah, this is what he does. It's only taking time from his clock, so he really shouldn't. So we do draw a prime time. Okay, that should do him in. That should really do him in. Yep. Get a Savannah and a Forest. It counters on all of her things. And he's good. Okay.
That was it. That was round one. Round two is right up.
But I'm gonna pause for a little convenience break. So, be right back. So, here we are for the second round of the Cubage. Oh, this hand has a potential very early Kozilek, so there's no way we're gonna mulligan this. No way, Jose. Mana Crypt. We are the best player in the Magic universe. This is filthy. If he force spikes us here, this is gonna be even filthier. What? No, and on camera we misclick show and tell. This is the worst. What the fuck, Modo? Why do you do this to me? This is what you get for getting overexcited. Okay, that never happened. Oh, we can get it back with Witness. Yeah, let's use heads. Yeah, heads. Oh, we can get a pack of witness right now. Okay. So we, yeah. Let me just do this. Do this. Witness it back. Yeah, that was embarrassing. Oh, and he even has to counterspell. Wow. 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 Ugh. And this one even. Yeah, okay. Okay, we're getting punished. We are getting punished. Like, hard. I don't even want to speak about it right now. I don't. Okay, so we're 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 mana, so we're not that far away from Harcast and Kozilek. Meanwhile, we're getting beaten to death by this Moloko. Yeah, heads. Rats. Okay. Okay, we're really in Harcast Emrakul territory. like really soon. This, for example. Yeah. Okay. Here is Trigon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So if we draw a Mana Vault, we can hard cast Emrakul, Kozilek. We keep calling him Emrakul, I think. Yeah, let's take 2 heads. Yeah, positive in heads. Oh, okay. We don't have double blue. That's bad. And we can't attack with the Trigon because he will just block it. So yeah, let's just say go. And he didn't make any tokens. That's okay, that means he doesn't have a removal. No blocks. Yeah, heads. No! The odds. What about the odds magic? Let's just cast a Thrag Feather to make this upheaval even better. Yeah, I mean, if we win this game, it doesn't really matter. But of course, it's still embarrassing to do this on camera. Like a classic motor brain fart. Which happens, just happens. We can't block anything. So we go down to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we're 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we're almost dead. Let's just draw blue mana. Blue mana. Heads. Yes. Ah, come on. The double blue card, really? Really, Modo? Yeah. So we're basically dead. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and you can make it. Yeah, we're dead. Rats. Let's see. No, wouldn't have gone there. Yeah. So let's not think about it too much, and just ship it back as it is. I think. I don't think we want any of these cards. Maybe the Stump Howler. He did show us his Mind Stone, but only the one Mind Stone doesn't want me to bring in Stump Howlers. I don't think. Yeah, the rest is basically okay against him. I think Stomp Power isn't better than the one Trigon Predator we have in our main board. So yeah, let me just pause the video. So let's play first. And this hand is basically trash, because this hand doesn't really do anything. We have one land. If we have more lands, it would be okay, so let's just mod it. Ugh. This hand isn't the best either. But I think I'm gonna keep it. I mean, we do have mana and some late game. And this deck doesn't really pressure us all that much. Ah, getting closer. Signet stuff out. Now next turn we're gonna have 4, 6 mana, so that's almost enough for Avenger. Yeah, so we're gonna resolve next turn Avenger, hopefully. If he doesn't have anything against it, we're not gonna run it into a counter. Of course we're not. And he doesn't have a counter, as it seems. Ooh, does that work? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then we have 4, 6 mana. No, that doesn't. That, unfortunately, doesn't work. But that does. And that does. Boom. There we have it. The old Avenger. Which is still not gonna do anything against his beatdown here. But if we should ever draw land, which lies within the realm of possibility, then we should be pretty fine. Or a prime time. Or a fetch land even. Or an upheaval. No way. But we could cast upheaval, at least. So, what will it be? Flame Tongue Kabu on the token. Okay. Heads. Yes, yes, heads. No! Come on. We started so good with the odds and everything. So now we can just... Question is basically if we want to trade a token for the Flametongue Kabu. Or if you just steal the Flametongue attack for 5. And then he hits us for 4, 8, 11, so we would have to lose both mana crypt flips. Or if we just steal the looter and draw ourselves into planes more quickly, that could also be something. Let's see. What is more reasonable? The looter he can probably kill easier. Yeah, I think we have to start doing some pressure here. So I'm just gonna treachery away the Flametongue. Not the Flametongue. What am I talking? I'm gonna treachery away the Serendip Ifrit. Oh, this also does damage to us, right? Yeah, okay, too bad. Oh, shut up, cat. Jeez. So yeah, we're doing some damage to him, but I mean, we're really not in a good position again because of stupid mana crypt. But our stupid mana crypt enabled us to be in the game still in the first place. So let's not blame mana crypt. Let's blame us for being crappy coin flippers. Wow, white mana would be so good, so good. And he gets the choice of good cards. You can choose between the good ones. Void Mage Prodigy. That's his best one, really. Let's choose Hetz again. Oh, come on! That can't be for real. And we draw a plane. I can talk. We draw a forest as well. How unlucky can one be? So let's just smack him. We could have played a land right before an attack with tokens, but I'd have no real interest in this. Let's use this ability. So now he's at 6. It's basically a race between Serendip Ifrit and Mana Crypt, so to speak. Attacks with everything, okay. Block here and block here. This frees our the Void Mage Prodigy. Oh no, now we can't lose any flips. But he has to have something that blocks the Avenger or trades with it at least. He doesn't seem to have that, but he has to have something. Heads, come on Heads, don't let me down. Don't let me down this time. No, damn it Heads. Winter Orb, not what we wanted. Yeah, we're probably dead. Yeah, he has to have cryptic command. Okay. Yeah, were two pretty awkward games. Yeah, we would have been quite a way away from the white one. Yeah, those were two pretty awkward games, but yeah, never mind. Okay, so see you guys.